Doesn't cost anything to make babies, but once they're born...
Hey, I've got a job.
And we're barely getting by.
How long do we have to wait till we can do it again?
Let's go to the movies sometime.
Is the movies all you had in mind?
I swear, just the movies, the whole movies, and nothing but the movies, so help me God.
I'll go to the movies with you, so long as you understand that what happened last night will never happen again till after I'm married. And you want to withdraw the invitation?
No. There's a new Robert Taylor movie showing at the Crichton. We can make the late show after my shift.
I've already seen it.
So? You saw his last movie 6 times.
Did I?
Is anything wrong?
No.
Thank you.
We could go do something else.
I can't. I'm busy tonight.
Ginger, you won't believe it. They sent free samples of coordinating nail polish. You pick first.
I don't want any.
Are you sure there's nothing wrong?
I'm sure.
What are you busy doing tonight?
That's my business.
When can we go out?
I don't know.
How can you not know?
If I say I don't know, that means I don't know. Because if I knew when, I'd say when, wouldn't I?
I'm gonna stock these later. I have some paperwork to do.
Are you sore at me?
No.
You sound like you're giving me the brush off.
Well, if I sound like that, then maybe I am.
What?
Do I have to paint a picture for you, Jeff?
It's not because I'm 2 years younger, is it?
No.
Or because I'm a ball player and you hate sports?
No.
Or because I don't like Robert Taylor?
Yes.
It's because I don't like Robert Taylor.
It's because of all those things put together, and not liking Robert Taylor is very important because it's the tip of the iceberg of not having anything in common. Every moment we spend together is a moment wasted because we have no future.
I don't buy that.
You have to buy it. I've made up my mind.
Just like that?
Just like that.
I don't have any say.
You can say goodbye.
Is there something wrong with Ginger?
I'll say.
Got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to be affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum, have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark,
donate the whale, no way in the yard.
What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said you got to accept.
You ain't the positive, eliminate the negative, and last on to the affirmative.
Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
Hi. Hi, Miss Metcalf.
Hi, Charlie.
I need some liniment for my wrist. I was lifting rods over at the factory. I think I pulled something.
I don't see any. I'm going to check in the back.
Hi, Ginger.
May I help you?
Miss Metcalf is, thanks. How have you been?
Fine, thank you. And you?
Fine. Is anything wrong?
Yes. I'm sick to death of people asking me if anything's wrong.
Jenny.
Don't you dare call me Jenny, you lousy two-timer. This is all your fault.
My fault?
If we'd gotten married like you promised, this would be your baby instead of somebody else's.
Baby?
Hey, Charlie.
So that's what you were bragging about at the bachelor party, huh?
What?
Ginger.
I didn't say anything about Ginger at the bachelor party.
You must have been bragging about some other woman.
As I recall, you didn't believe a thing I had said.
I do now. Now I may scramble you.
Shove off, Charlie. If I want to date Ginger, that's my business.
She was a virgin, for Pete's sake.
Who said she's not?
You think she's some kind of cheap dame?
I think Ginger's none of your damn business.
None of my damn business?
You dumped her. You're out of the picture.
I'm not out of the picture yet.
You're gonna do right by her.
What is that supposed to mean?
You're gonna marry her.
That's no reason to get married.
I've heard some low stuff in my life. Ow! If I could give that baby a name, I would, but I can't. But you're going to, mister.
Baby. Ginger? Hey, wait a second, Ginger. Ginger, wait! Could you watch the counter? Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't want you to know.
Are you sure?
I'm 2 weeks late. I've never been late in my life.
We only did it once.
That's all it takes, or haven't you heard? Besides, it was twice. Same night, but it was twice. I should have said no the first time, let alone the second. I'm not only a tramp, I'm a pregnant tramp.
You're not a tramp, and you're... Maybe you're not.
Anticipating a blessed event?
So what are we gonna do?
We're not gonna do anything. I'm moving away.
Ginger.
No, I am. I've had 2 whole weeks to think about it, and I decided that the best course of action is to move to another town, change my name, and start over. Say my husband was killed in war.
Ginger.
I'll work in a drugstore till the baby comes, and then I'll work out of my apartment so I can take care of it. It's fine, because I can sew pretty well, and...
Don't you think I should have some say in the matter?
No.
Well, maybe I want to take in sewing. I know how to sew. Anyways, this is something we have to face together. Have you talked to a doctor yet?
No, I can't go to my regular doctor. He treats half the city.
Then we'll go to another one. Don't worry, it'll be all right.
Says you.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
It smells good.
It's the filling to shepherd's pie. I thought I could put it on toast. Charlie, what happened to your hand?
Hank's kid brother got my goat.
You should wash up so I can bandage it. His brother hurt your hand.
In a manner of speaking. I threw a punch at him and I nailed the wall.
Why?
He wasn't doing right by Ginger.
That woman you were engaged to?
Yeah.
You got in a fight over that woman you were engaged to?
Not over her. I got into a fight because Jeff was being a louse.
To that woman?
Ow! It wasn't a real fight.
What right do you have to say anything about her?
She's an old friend. I wouldn't let anyone treat an old friend the way he's treating her.
And how is he treating her?
She's in a family way.
What has any of this got to do with you, Charlie Haley?
Caroline, come on. I would do the same thing for you.
You don't fight over an old girlfriend unless you're carrying a torch for her.
Caroline.
How dare you get in a fight about that woman? How dare you?
I am not going to let her raise a kid by herself.
Maybe you'd like to be the father.
Maybe I would.
You want a divorce so you can marry the pregnant sow? Is that what you want?
At least I'd be married to a wife who wants kids instead of what I have, which is a nag.
Then go ahead and do it. Marry her and have a whole litter of her children. I'll have a beer.
That'll be 15 cents.
May I?
Thanks.
This place is all right. Come here often?
I don't get out much.
Now, that's a crying shame. Where are you from?
England. Huh. Hi, Caroline.
Hey, Caroline.
Evening.
Sarah, I got a table if you care to join us.
Oh, thanks. Maybe later.
Where's Charlie?
He's at home. He hurt his hand today.
Was it serious?
No.
You sure you don't want to join us?
I can't. This gentleman just asked me to dance.
Oh. Well, later then.
I hope you weren't just using me to give them the brusheroo because I'm an excellent dancer.
I bet you are.
Ben. Ben Mahoney.
Come in. How was class?
47 years ago, our fathers brought forth onto this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal.
That's proposition. The rest is great.
My English is getting better.
It's aces, kiddo. I don't know how much use you'll have for 40. And I can never remember how long it is, and I'm a native. You hungry?
Yes, please. Where's Caroline?
She pulled a long face and skedaddled.
What?
Vamoosed.
Vamoosed.
She's green in the eye. She thinks I'm carrying a torch for an old flame.
You carry the torch.
In a pig's eye, I do. She got sour on me. She can go to Blue Blazes. Nothing I do makes her happy. Most dames would be happy to have a guy who brings home the bacon. But she has to live high on the hog. Well, that's her beef.
I will never learn English.
Well, here we are.
It's my home away from home.
It's nice.
Not worry. She's only staying out to make you worry.
It's working.
You take this and you go to work.
What if something happened to her?
If something happened, she would have called.
What if she was too hurt to call? She could have been hit by a bus.
Caroline is very smart. She wanted to make you worry, and she has.
You think she went back to England?
I think she spent the night at the hotel. And I think she's very bad to you. You take this and you go to work. And when she comes home, I'll telephone you.
Okay. Don't tell her I was worried.
I will tell her you slept like a baby.
You are one terrific dame. What a night.
Do you have anything to drink?
Coffee coming right up. I make my own on the road. This used to be my least favorite stop. I've only got a one-night layover here. Whereas I got 3 days in Toledo. But you just pushed River Run to the top of my chart. Hey, what say we make a stand-in date for the first Monday of every month?
What say we don't?
What's got under your skin?
Where are my clothes?
I folded them. I'll get them.
What time is it?
It's 10 to 8. Listen, honey, I'm a salesman, so what I do best is talk, but you got me tripping all over my tongue. I didn't mean that to sound insulting. I was trying to find out if I could see you again, only I was doing it all wrong. See, I figured if I made light of the invite and you turned me down, I could save my pride. But you're a knockout, and I don't care if I make a fool of myself. What can I do to see you again?
I don't want to be in your black book. On Monday, it's Caroline in River Run. Tuesday, it's Lucinda in Toledo. Come Thursday, it's Betty in God knows where.
That's what everybody thinks of traveling salesmen. If that's the way it really was, sweetie, the world would be full to overflowing with traveling salesmen. Come with me. I've only got one call to make today, and then I'm headed to Toledo. After that, Chicago. I'll show you the whole damn state of Illinois, and I'll show it to you in style. I get 10% of everything I sell, and I'm the top salesman on the road. I'm not locked in some factory making slave wages 10 hours a day. Anything keeping you here?
Oh, really?
Then pack your bags and meet me outside of Cochran's Hardware at noon.
What did you and Caroline fight about?
Who said we were fighting?
Oh, she came into the roadhouse alone last night. Anybody could put two and two together.
Did she look down in the dumps?
Nah. She was having the time of her life.
Ah! Damn! I just lost my hand. You need a doctor?
No, I'm all right. I'm all right.
What was Caroline doing?
Not much.
What's not much?
Not much.
Drinking?
She might have had a beer.
Was she dancing?
A little. You can tell she was just doing it for show.
How do you know it was for show? Maybe she was having the time of her life.
All your friends go there, Charlie. She just wanted it to get back to you.
Swell, she wants everyone to know we were fighting. I should get her a spot on the Jack Benny Show and broadcast it live, coast to coast. Next time you see my wife out on town without me, you call me.
All right, fair enough. And what's she sore about?
Jeff didn't tell you?
Tell me what?
I got sore at Jeff because he's dating Ginger, and Caroline wasn't too wild about me fighting over an old flame.
You and Jeff had a fight?
It wasn't really a fight. I just wanted to make sure he was being square with her.
Jeff's a stand-up guy.
Well, he better be.
Doesn't need you to tell him what to do.
It says you.
Did your parents ask a lot of questions?
I said I was going to see Aunt Winona because she was sick, and they haven't spoken a word to her since she married a divorced man, so they'll never know.
What does the doctor charge?
$6 for a first-time patient and $2 for the test.
I only have 5.
I have 8.
Well, we're doing all right then.
I made some pimento cheese sandwiches, so we don't have to buy lunch.
Toledo? Here we come.
Mrs. Abo? And Medcalf. I need to reach Jeff in Toledo. No emergency. I want him to pick up a sweater I ordered from Houghton's. Well, any divorce is a scandal. But if I call your sister, she wouldn't have to know how I got the number. Thanks. I promise I won't tell her. Operator, I'd like to place a call to Toledo.
Caroline, are you home? Caroline? Gina? Gina?
Thanks, it's my mother's recipe. How many more miles until Toledo?
It looks like 16. We'll make it to the doctor's in plenty of time.
Jeff, I always wanted kids. I did. And then when Charlie dumped me, I realized I couldn't depend on a man. I had to become self-sufficient. So I sat myself down and had a talk with me. And I reevaluated my goals. And I realized I wanted to be an actress.
An actress?
Well, I'll never get to Hollywood now. I don't have any money. I'll be a bachelor mother. Threw away my life. What's worse, I don't have anything to give my baby.
Sure you do. You'll make a fabulous mother. You'll give the baby... There is a baby. You'll give the baby all the spunk you have. And I think I'll make a pretty good father. Ginger, will you marry me?
Oh, Jeff.
That's nothing to cry about.
You wouldn't propose if I weren't expecting a visit from the stork.
Yes, I would. I'd love you. I'd have gotten around to it eventually.
I can't marry you.
Why?
Because of the circumstances.
These are exactly the circumstances you should get married under.
I could never be sure you weren't doing it out of obligation.
I'm not.
Thanks for asking. But no thanks.
You have it on good authority that this doctor's okay.
I mean, he knows his stuff, doesn't he? I don't want you going to anybody who isn't 100% okay.
Working at a drugstore, I hear the scuttlebutt on every doctor in the state.
Then that's that.
Wait. They're from the 5 and 10. It's silly, I know. I mean, who cares what strangers think? But I figured it's going to be rugged enough as time goes by, and I'd rather not face the worst of it right off the bat. So just for the time being, I'd like to look like we're in the up and up.
I never thought about wearing a wedding ring.
Mrs. Miller? Mrs. Miller?
Yes, yes, yes.
That street address you gave us, is that local?
Yes.
You forgot to put Toledo on this line.
I'm sorry.
What part of town is that?
North.
You mean north?
I always get turned around in this building.
The doctor's ready for you. Mr. Miller?
Yes, I am.
Well, you'll have to wait here. Right this way, Mrs. Miller.
I knew you were good luck. I've been trying to land this hardware account for 6 months, and I couldn't even get the owner to talk to me. Now he's agreed to let me buy a mistake.
Did he place a big order?
Yeah, that's for after dinner, after he's softened up. We sit back, we have a good smoke, then I unload my whole line. Got this for you.
It's lovely.
Well, I want you to look your best tonight.
I thought it was a business dinner.
I couldn't leave you alone in a hotel. Thought you might like a steak yourself.
You're so sweet, Ben.
You have a very healthy young wife, Mr. Miller.
Is she, are we expecting?
Well, I can't tell that until I've seen the test results.
When will that be?
Oh, a few days, depending on how backed up the laboratory technician is. I'll have my nurse call you with the results just as soon as we get word.
Oh, you can't call. We don't have a phone.
Well, then we'll mail them to you.
You can't do that either.
We just moved, and the post office keeps sending our mail to the dead letter office.
But we can call you ourselves in a few days.
Fine. You know, I can't help noticing that you seem a little anxious. You know, I've been in practice for a long time, and I can recognize a problem when I see one. So if you don't mind a little advice from a man who's been in the business for a long time, you should relax. The best way to have a baby is to just relax. Hmm?
I have one more stop, then dinner.
I'm stopped.
We're in Toledo. Why don't we go sightseeing?
I don't feel much like sightseeing.
Get something to eat?
We only have $1.50 left.
That's a lot.
But we might have a flat on the way home, and we wouldn't be able to have it fixed, and we'd have to spend the night in the car, only get so cold we'd freeze to death, so then we'd have to rent a hotel room.
Ginger! If all that happens, $1.50's not gonna help anyway. So can I buy you a cup of coffee?
And a piece of chocolate pie.
What a chocolate pie it is.
I was thinking about it all the way down here.
Then I'll find you a piece.
Which means I have cravings, because I was thinking chocolate pie all the way down here. Do you know what cravings mean?
Ginger.
Ginger's aunt has never been sick a day in her life.
So what?
Why would Jeff tell me she's sick when she's not?
Oh, hi, Ruth.
And Metcalf. I hadn't realized you work here.
Well, since I was laid off at your plant. Since October.
And Hank, hello.
Hello, Miss Sloan.
Can I get you something?
Coffee if it's fresh. Tea if it's not. Black, while I wait for my prescription.
It bothers me no end, Jeff being so secretive. Not telling us who he's dating, sneaking out, lying to borrow the car, lying about where he's going.
Typical.
What's typical?
Oh, nothing. Thank you.
Maybe Ginger's aunt was sick, and she got better.
There are people who refuse to admit it when they're sick.
It's very generous of you to give your son the benefit of the doubt.
I try to do that with all my children.
We all do. I did mine. Much good it did me. Wish now I had stepped in. I had intervened. But who knew? My son was gone. He didn't confide in me any more than yours confide in you. When they say we don't understand, they mean we won't agree. So rather than ask for advice, they act impulsively, which, when you think you're in love, is... Well, I am carrying on, aren't I?
I never thought of your son as impulsive.
You don't call eloping impulsive?
I didn't elope. What? I mean, he told everybody.
He told us when there was nothing we could do about it.
Do you think my son eloped with Ginger?
I'm sure I'm wrong about it. Anyway, you'll know soon enough.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
Maybe she's trying to scare you.
Staying out one night... scaring me. Packing a bag and leaving, well, that's something else, isn't it?
Maybe she will come back.
Who wants her to? I work my fingers to the bone and all she does is complain. We don't have a phonograph. We don't go dancing. I never hear you complain about anything. And you don't have two nickels to rub together.
I have been very lucky.
Lucky? Your family's dead. Your husband's dead. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make you feel bad.
No, I don't have the English to explain. I almost died in the war. I am with the Germans, and they are killing people. And I am next to die. And I try not to be scared, and I think of Mike. I met Mike before the Germans came. And then I am next to die. But the American soldiers come and they save me.
Where were you?
It doesn't matter. What matters is that I live.
You were next to die?
Yes. 2 weeks later, Mike found me. I never expected to see him again. And then we are together. And now I have the baby. So I think I'm very lucky.
Caroline won't talk about the war. I know it was rough. I know she went hungry. And I guess she figures by staying with me, she might go hungry again. So I don't know what else to do, Gina. I'm trying. I'm trying the best I know how.
The transmission doesn't fail. We don't get stuck in a blizzard. We might make it home.
I don't know why I've been so down in the dumps lately. Who cares what people think anyway?
That's the spirit.
Caroline.
Hello.
Hi.
Fancy all of us running into each other.
In Toledo.
What are you here for? My aunt's
sightseeing.
Sick.
We went to see her aunt and then we went sightseeing. How about you and Charlie? Why are you here?
Charlie couldn't make it.
I see.
I wanted to do some sightseeing, too. See America.
Toledo's a great city.
It is, isn't it?
But we have to pull ourselves away and hit the road. Bye.
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 I can't believe I ran into her.
She doesn't know why we came.
Oh, my... Jeff, we had our rings on.
No, she didn't see them.
I'm gonna die. I'm gonna curl up and die right here on the spot.
No, you're not.
How do you know? I might just very well do that. Dad's sister was mortified when she found out she was pregnant at 38, and it turned out she wasn't at all. She was sick. And she died.
You stop that kind of thinking. You stop it now. Enough of the gloom and doom. I'd rather you be having a baby than be sick any day of the week.
Just give me the ring back.
It doesn't feel half bad. I'll take it off when we get back.
Oh, Jeff.
I'm trying to develop a taste for coffee, but I'm really not that keen on it yet.
Keen on it? I could listen to you talk all night.
I don't really hear the difference that much myself, but I do know I get some of the words wrong. I still say bonnet instead of car hood. Charlie says I'll never learn.
Who's Charlie?
My brother, he came over here 2 years before me, so his American's a lot better than mine.
You tell Charlie, I think your American is just fine. Would you excuse me for a moment?
Sure.
You're doing great. We're gonna make a killing.
That's wonderful. When are you going to show him the samples?
Tomorrow.
I thought you said after dinner.
After dinner comes dancing.
Smashing.
Then we'll meet back at the hotel and we'll celebrate.
Meet?
Yeah, I'm bushed. I want to take a load off. You and Brownlee can go out together. I don't mind.
I don't want to go without you.
Hey, you'll have a swell time. The guy's swimming in dough.
But I don't want to go without you.
It's only dancing.
I don't want to.
You have to be nice to the customers.
I don't have to be anything.
Be a good scout, huh?
A good scout? Is that what you call it in American?
Don't be a chump. This man's a fairy godfather.
Have you ever been dancing at the Egyptian Room?
No, I haven't.
There's a skyline view. You up for it, Ben?
I'm bushed. I think I'll go back to the hotel and take a load off. Caroline might enjoy it.
What do you say?
I say a whore is a whore, and I don't do it for steak and a city view. How was Toledo?
Fine. Get poor sick Auntie Winona all patched up, did we?
She's feeling better.
Jeff, we know that Ginger's aunt wasn't sick.
What?
I called Mrs. Burton. She didn't know anything about you and Ginger visiting. She said she was feeling fine.
She said she was feeling fine.
Lame, little brother. Very lame.
Oh, for pity's sake, the way this family beats around the bush. Did you get married?
Did I get married?
Elope, tie the knot, get hitched.
No.
Oh, thank God.
What made you think that?
Well, Slugger, you fibbed about the car. You got in a fight with Charlie over Ginger.
Can't blame us for thinking the worst.
The worst? I think Ginger is swell. I think I could do a lot worse.
So you are planning on getting married?
Well, if I ever do, I guarantee I will elope rather than have all of you looking over my shoulder as I go down the aisle.
Jeff.
What?
Why did you go to Toledo?
I told you. Ginger's aunt was sick.
I talked to the woman. Why would you say she's fine if she's not?
Well, that's what's wrong with the lady. She doesn't know what she's saying. She says she's fine when she's sick, sick when she's fine. She's all mixed up in the head. She thought the mailman was her husband.
I wonder why Mrs. Sabo never mentioned it.
The family's embarrassed by her.
I'll bet you didn't remember you were there.
Probably not.
Well, I'd put money on it.
Forget it. Gina, a team of wild horses couldn't drag me to work. I don't care about work.
You always need a lunch.
I'm going to the Red Cross. I'm going to see if they've heard anything from her. I'll go clear to England if I have to.
Let me get my key out.
Where the hell have you been?
A YWCA?
I called the Y.
I didn't use my real name.
Hank said you were at the Roadhouse.
I was.
Did you meet any fellas?
Yes.
Did you forget you were a married woman?
I didn't forget.
Why'd you walk out on me?
Because I was angry.
And why'd you come back?
Because I missed you.
Ha.
It's true.
You make me feel like I'm this tall, like I'm nothing. And you think you can waltz back in here, pretty as you please, and I'll take you back?
No, I don't. I'm sorry, Charlie.
You ever do that again, you ever walk out on me again, and I'll change the locks. You understand?
Yes.
So tomorrow's the day, huh?
Yeah.
What time do you want to call the doctor?
As early as possible, I guess.
Okay.
Say 8 o'clock?
8 o'clock.
Yes, my name is Susie Miller. I was calling about my test to see if we're having a baby.
What'd she say?
Just looking for the results. I came in on Tuesday, if that helps. Could you kind of hurry? I've only got 3 minutes. Must be wrong. Uh-huh. Could it be anything else? Uh-huh. Okay, thanks. Bye. I'm not.
What are you crying for? Is something else wrong?
No. No, they said it was nerves. I probably missed my time of the month because of nerves, and if I just calm down, everything will be okay. I like Toledo.
I didn't even see it. You can make it to Hollywood now.
If I apply myself. Oh, no.
What?
I told Charlie I was having a baby, and now I'm not, and now everybody will know I'm a trans.
You said it's silly to care what people think.
Well, that's when I was being brave. I don't have to be brave anymore.
Well, at least you quit crying. Ginger?
What?
I want you to know I meant what I said.
What?
On the way to Toledo.
You're not obligated to stick by that.
I know it.
There's no reason to even talk about marriage now.
I stand by what I said.
Well, I'm turning you down.
Oh.
There's one thing I have to tell you, so you'll know it didn't have anything to do with whether there was a baby or not.
What?
I meant it when I said I love you. Well, don't cry.
Jeff, I love you too. But we are never doing that again. Never. Never, ever. No.
I'm Ted Koppel. Later on Nightline, did the Reagan campaign try to delay the release of American hostages? Congress is on the verge of investigating. Tonight, an author who says there really was an October surprise and a journalist who says it's all nonsense.
Friday, can a person be thrown out of school or work because they're too fat? It happened to 280-pound Sharon Russell. Her story on 2020.